The Startling Adventures of Baron Munchausen, adapted by Rudolf Erich Raspe. Narration, Katie Haigh. An Adventure with a Lion and a Crocodile. Some years before my beard announced approaching manhood, or, in other words, when I was neither man nor boy, but between both, I expressed in repeated conversations a strong desire of seeing the world, from which I was discouraged by my parents, though my father had been no inconsiderable traveller himself. A cousin by my mother's side took a liking to me, often said I was a fine, forward youth, and was much inclined to gratify my curiosity. His eloquence had more effect than mine, for my father consented to my accompanying him in a voyage to the island of Ceylon, where his uncle had resided as governor for many years. We sailed from Amsterdam with dispatches from their high mightinesses, the States of Holland, and in about 6 weeks we arrived at Ceylon, where we were received with great marks of friendship and true politeness. After we had resided at Ceylon about a fortnight, I accompanied one of the governor's brothers upon a shooting party. Near the banks of a large piece of water, which had engaged my attention, I thought I heard a rustling noise behind. On turning about, I was almost petrified, as who would not be, at the sight of a lion, which was evidently approaching with the intention of satisfying his appetite with my poor carcass, and that without asking my consent. What was to be done in this horrible dilemma? I had not even a moment for reflection. My piece was only charged with swan shot, and I had no other about me. However, though I could have no idea of killing such an animal with that weak kind of ammunition, yet I had some hopes of frightening him by the report, and perhaps of wounding him also. I immediately let fly, without waiting till he was within reach, and the report did but enrage him, for he now quickened his pace, and seemed to approach me full speed. I attempted to escape, but that only added, if an addition could be made, to my distress. For the moment I turned about, I found a large crocodile, with his mouth extended almost ready to receive me. On my right hand was the piece of water before mentioned, and on my left a deep precipice, said to have, as I have since learned, a receptacle at the bottom for venomous creatures. In short, I gave myself up as lost, for the lion was now upon his hind legs, just in the act of seizing me. I fell involuntarily to the ground with fear, and, as it afterward appeared, he sprang over me. I lay some time in a situation which no language can describe, expecting to feel his teeth or talons in some part of me every moment. After waiting in this prostrate situation a few seconds, I heard a violent but unusual noise, differing from any sound that had ever before assailed my ears. Nor is it at all to be wondered at when I inform you from whence it proceeded. After listening for some time, I ventured to raise my head and look around, when, to my unspeakable joy, I perceived the lion had, by the eagerness with which he sprang at me, jumped forward, as I fell, into the crocodile's mouth, which, as before observed, was wide open. The head of the one stuck in the throat of the other, and they were struggling to extricate themselves. I fortunately recollected my hunting knife, which was by my side. With this instrument, I severed the lion's head at one blow, and the body fell at my feet. I then, with the butt end of my fowling piece, rammed the head farther into the throat of the crocodile and destroyed him by suffocation, for he could neither gorge nor eject it. Soon after I had thus gained a complete victory over my two powerful adversaries, my companion arrived in search of me. For finding I did not follow him into the wood, he returned, apprehending I had lost my way or met with some accident. After mutual congratulations, we measured the crocodile, which was just 40 feet in length. Crossing the Thames without the aid of bridge, boat, or balloon. My first visit to England was about the beginning of George III's reign. I had occasion to go down to Wapping to see some goods shipped, which I was sending to some friends at Hamburg. After that business was over, I took the Tower Wharf in my way back. Here I found the sun very powerful, and I was so much fatigued that I stepped into one of the cannon to compose me, where I fell fast asleep. This was about noon.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.